Okay. So is it visible, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. In the last class, we stopped at the dot product or the scalar product. In continuation with that, next one is the vector product or the cross product. Consider the two vectors A bar and B bar. Now, if you want to define the cross product of these two vectors, that is A bar and B bar, it is denoted as A bar into B bar. The cross product is denoted as A bar into B bar, and it is defined as the product of the magnitude of the vector A and the magnitude of vector B and the sine of the angle theta between the two vectors A bar and B bar. How it is defined? Cross product is denoted as A bar into B bar, and it is defined as the product of the magnitude of the vector A and the magnitude of the vector B and the sine of the angle theta between the two vectors A bar and B bar. Is it only this much or anything else? Let us see that. This product is a vector quantity. Let us see how it is a vector quantity. And it has the direction perpendicular to the direction of the given two vectors A bar and B bar. Okay. This cross product or vector product is a vector quantity, and it has the direction perpendicular to the direction of the given two vectors A bar and B bar. Direction of this cross product. How to decide the direction of the cross product? If you want to know the direction, then we have to follow a rule called as screw rule. According to this screw rule, the direction of the rotation of the screw, that gives the direction of the cross product, or that gives the direction of the vector which is perpendicular to the two vectors in the plane, that is A bar and B bar vectors. Direction of the cross product is along the perpendicular direction. See here. Direction of the cross product is along the perpendicular direction to the plane which is in the direction of the advancement of a screw when turned A bar is into B bar. Okay. Direction of the cross product is along the perpendicular direction to the plane, along the perpendicular direction to the plane. And in that plane, which are the two vectors? A bar and B bar are the two vectors. Then if I turn A bar into B bar, whatever is the direction of the screw, it may be in clockwise or in anticlockwise, that direction of the screw will give us the direction of the cross product. That will give us the direction of cross product. That is, the screw movement direction decides the direction of the cross product. The direction of the screw decides the direction of the cross product. It may be in the upward direction or in the downward direction. Let us just look into that by seeing these figures. This is how I have represented the two vectors. One is A bar, another one is B bar in the plane. This is a plane. They are coplanar vectors in the same plane, A bar and B bar. In this A bar and B bar vectors, if I am considering, then I have represented a screw here. I have represented a screw. If I move this A bar vector into B bar vector, right? I am moving the A bar vector towards the B bar vector. If I move A bar towards B bar, what will be the direction of the screw? Whether it is clockwise or anticlockwise. I am moving A bar vector towards the B bar vector. Then what will be the direction of rotation of this screw, whether it is in clockwise or anticlockwise?
It will be
in the anticlockwise direction. Okay, fine. Now, A bar, when it is moved into B bar, A bar it is moved into B bar, that means you are rotating the screw in the anticlockwise direction. Are you tightening the screw or are you loosening the screw in anticlockwise direction? When you rotate the screw, okay, with your screwdriver, right, whether it will be in anticlockwise direction, whether you are loosening the screw or whether you are tightening the screw?
Loosening
the screw. Whenever you are rotating the screw in the screwdriver in the anticlockwise direction, the screw will be loosened. It will try to loosen. Okay. If you are rotating the clockwise direction, you are tightening the screw. rotating your screwdriver in the clockwise direction, you are tightening the screw. Okay, that is how the screw will be loosened. It is loosening the screw in the anti-clockwise direction. When you are loosening the screw, what will happen? The screw will come out. It will go in the upward direction. The direction of the cross product will be in the upward direction. That is what is shown here. Advancement of screw in the upward direction. That is AN bar. Okay. This is one. Then another figure it is showing. This is A bar is moved into B bar. Here also A bar is moved into B bar. But look the difference between the two figures. Okay. Here there is A bar. Here it is B bar. And here is A bar and this is our B bar. If I move A bar towards B bar, both are in the same plane. They are coplanar vectors. If I move A bar towards B bar, whether I am tightening the screw or loosening the screw, here in this particular tightening the screw, I am moving in the clockwise direction. Okay, I am moving in the clockwise direction. So when I am moving the screw in the clockwise direction, I am tightening the screw. Okay, so when the screw is getting tightened, then the direction of the cross product will be in the downward direction. You are rotating the screw in the clockwise direction. So the screw will slowly, it will go on rotating in the clockwise direction in towards the downward direction. And hence the direction of the cross product AN bar will be in the downward direction. Okay. This is how we have to decide the direction of the cross product based on when we move the A bar vector, first vector into the second vector, whether the direction of the screw is in clockwise direction, that is in the upward direction, or in anti-clockwise direction, or in the downward direction. Based on those directions, we have to decide the direction of the cross product. Fine. What is the mathematical representation of the cross product then? The mathematical representation of the cross product is given by A bar cross B bar. That is, look here, there is a slight change in the definition that we defined earlier. It is the magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar to sine of angle theta between A and B vectors multiplied by the direction, that is the unit vector of the two given vectors A bar and B bar. Okay, here the direction also comes into picture. Okay, whenever it is a cross product, it is a magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector into sine of angle theta. In the dot product, what it was? Cosine of angle theta. Instead of sine, it was cosine. And there was no unit vector there. It's a dot product. It's a magnitude just. But here you are getting the direction. And hence, here it is AN bar, the direction of the cross product or the direction of the unit vector. Where AN is the unit vector perpendicular to the plane of A and B. That is what is shown in the figure here. When A bar is moved into B bar, it is AN bar unit vector in the upward direction, which is the direction of the cross product. Or when A bar is moved into B bar, in the second figure, the direction of AN bar is unit vector is in the downward direction. Next, we will go through the properties of the cross product. We have seen in the last class properties of the dot product or the scalar product. Next is properties of the cross product. Commutative law is not applicable to cross product. You have to tell me the reason. Why commutative law cannot be applied to the cross product? What is the reason? A bar dot B bar is equal to B bar dot A bar. Scalar product, it agrees. But when it is cross product, A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar. Why? What may be the reason? Can you just think of it? A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar. What may be the reason? Yes, please.
Direction, sir.
The direction.
Nice, nice. Correct answer. So A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar because of the directions. When we know that when it is A bar cross B bar, A bar cross B bar, we are moving the vector A into the vector B. I'm showing in the figure here. Look here. When it is A bar moved into B bar in the first figure, the direction of the unit vector is upwards. Direction of the unit vector is upwards. Okay. This is A bar moved into B bar. In the second figure, B bar is moved towards A bar. that is B cross A, B bar cross A bar. When B bar is moved towards A bar, what is the direction of the unit vector? It will be in the downward direction. Screw moving in the downward direction, direction of the screw. Okay. Hence, we say that because there is change in the directions for A bar cross B bar and B bar cross A bar, we say that the commutative law does not hold good for the cross product. Commutative law is not applicable, it does not agree for the cross product. That is, A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar. Okay. Then what is true? If A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar, then what is true here? Is it so that A bar cross B bar is equal to minus of B bar cross A bar? Is it like that?
Yes, sir.
Exactly. A bar cross B bar is equal to minus of B bar cross A bar. So can I call it as anti-commutative? This statement, A bar cross B bar is equal to minus of B bar cross A bar. Can I call it as anti-commutative?
Yes, sir.
Of course, is it not? Commutative means A bar cross B bar is equal to B bar cross A bar. If it is A bar cross B bar is equal to minus of B bar cross A bar, that means magnitudes are same. A bar cross B bar magnitude is equal to magnitude of B bar cross A bar. But what is the change? It is opposite in direction. Opposite in direction. A bar cross B bar and B bar cross A bar has the same magnitude, but they are having opposite directions. Okay, that is the meaning of anti-commutative. Anti-commutative. That is our next point. A bar cross B bar is equal to minus B bar cross A bar. That is, they are both anti-commutative in nature. What about the associative property of the cross product? Here, when we consider the cross product associative property, that is A into B into C, right? That is not equal to A into B into C, or A bar cross of B bar cross C bar is not equal to A bar cross of B bar cross C bar. The cross product is not applicable to the associative property. Associative property does not hold good for the cross product. Then let us see the distributive property. The distributive property applied to the cross product. That is A bar cross of B bar plus C bar. A bar cross of B bar plus C bar. This is how we represent the distributive property, is it not? A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. That is, A bar cross of B bar plus C bar is equal to A bar cross B bar plus A bar cross C bar. That means distributive property is holding good for the cross product. Okay. Distributive property holds good for the cross product. It agrees for the cross product. Next. If the two vectors are in the same direction, what will be their cross product? Let us say A bar and B bar, these are the two vectors, they are in the same direction. What is the meaning of they are in the same direction? What is the meaning of they are in the same direction? Anyone?
Zero, sir.
Theta is 0 degrees because they are in the same direction. Meaning of they are in the same direction is they are parallel to each other. They are parallel to each other. When they are parallel to each other, the angle theta is 0 degrees. When angle theta is 0 degrees, what is our formula for the cross product? A bar cross B bar is equal to magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine 0. Theta is 0 into An bar. When sine 0 is 0, this entire RHS becomes 0. Hence, A bar cross B bar will be 0. Our cross product will be 0. When the two vectors are parallel to each other or when they are in the same direction, because the angle theta will be 0 degrees. Next point. If what is the cross product of the vector with itself? What is the cross product? Let us say we are having the vector A. If we are multiplying the vector A, if we are taking the cross product of vector A with itself, then what will be the value? Cross product of vector A with itself. What will be the value? Can anybody?
Zero. Yes.
Because the sign is again sign of zero only. vector A is taken the cross product of with the same vector. Again, they are in the same direction. Same direction means they are parallel, right? Because it's the same vector, both are the same vectors. Angle is zero and hence sine zero. When it is sine zero, again the cross product according to our formula, again it will be zero only. Hence, the cross product of vector A with the vector B, vector A with itself, cross product of the vector A with itself is always zero, remember. Okay, so what it means, friends, if the two vectors are parallel to each other, then their cross product is always zero. That is, cross product of vector A with itself is calculated, it is zero as theta is zero. That is, A bar cross A bar is equal to zero. A bar cross A bar is equal to zero. Next, if we consider in the Cartesian system, we are considering the Cartesian system. In the Cartesian system, let us say there are three unit vectors, AX bar, AY bar, and AZ bar. What is the meaning of unit vectors? Unit vectors means one point on the unit vector is magnitude is one, correct? You are right. Another point is that the unit vectors are the vectors which are mutually perpendicular to each other. That is also one more point on the unit vectors. When we consider the unit vectors AX bar, AY bar, and AZ bar in the X direction, Y direction, and Z direction, okay, of the Cartesian system or in any other systems as a matter, then these unit vectors are perpendicular to each other. They are mutually perpendicular to each other. Okay. Then we can think of the cross product of X with Y, Y with Z, and Z with X. Yes or no? That is X to Y, Y to Z, and Z to X. Unit vector cross products. When we consider the cross product of AX bar cross AY bar, then what will be the cross product? AX bar cross AY bar. Just give a thought on it. AX bar cross AY bar will be what? Just think and tell me. Or you can work out there and tell me what will be AX bar cross AY bar. Just it requires a little thinking. AX bar cross AY bar. Yes, please. Any answers?
One cross.
How much it is?
One.
Just try out. It is not one. AX bar cross AY bar. You have to think a little bit.
Sir, magnitude of AX bar into magnitude of AY bar.
Okay, magnitude of AX bar into magnitude of AY bar, fine. According to the formula, it is okay. But what will be the AX bar cross AY bar product? Final answer. What will be the final answer? Work out on your book, on your book. First, write down the formula. AX bar cross AY bar is equal to magnitude of AX bar, this one. Magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar, or magnitude of AX bar into magnitude of AY bar. Sine of angle theta, right, into AN bar. Write down this formula. Then go on substituting accordingly. What will you get there? Yes, please. Anybody getting the any other answers? Yes. Anybody getting any other answers? Look here. AX bar, what is the magnitude of AX bar? Unit vector AX bar. Yes. Magnitude of unit vector AX bar is how much?
1, sir.
Magnitude of unit vector 1. Okay. Similarly, magnitude of AY bar, unit vector AY bar is also 1. Okay. So these two terms, what will happen here according to our formula here? Magnitude of AX bar is 1, magnitude of B, that is AY bar is 1. Okay. So this will be 1. Product of A bar into B bar is 1. Sine of angle theta. Sine of angle theta between A to B vector is how much? What is the angle there between unit vector AX bar and unit vector AY bar? Angle between the unit vectors. 90 degrees, exactly. 90 degrees. Sine of 90. Sine of 90 is also 1. Okay. So we got this product. A bar into B bar into sine theta is 1. Okay. What about AN bar? AX bar cross AY bar will cause into which vector? Or what will be the cross product? Unit vector direction. Direction of the unit vector. Or what will be the unit vector? AN bar.
AZ bar.
Excellent. It will be AZ bar. Okay. Because I'll show it in the figure here. This is our AX bar. This is our AY bar. This is our AZ bar. Okay, in the X direction, YZ direction, and in the Z direction, which are perpendicular to each other. Now, when we move X into Y, or when we move AX bar into AY bar, the resulting cross product will be in the AZ bar direction. Okay, what you're doing, you're loosening the screw. AX bar is moved into AY bar. Think of the loosening the screw in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay. When you are loosening the screw, the direction will be in the upward. That is, the direction will be in the AZ bar direction, in the AZ bar direction. And hence, AN bar unit vector is AZ bar. That means what? AX bar cross AY bar is equal to AZ bar. Similarly, AY bar cross AZ bar is equal to AX bar. And then AX bar cross AY bar, sorry, AZ bar cross AX bar will be AY bar. What are the three we are getting equations here? AX bar cross AY bar is equal to AZ bar. Then AY bar cross AZ bar is equal to AX bar. AZ bar cross AX bar is equal to AY bar. You have to take in the anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction. Only then the signs will be positive. If you take in the reverse direction, if you just change the order of the terms, if you take in the opposite direction, clockwise direction, or if you change the order of the terms, then their cross product will be negative. Okay, we will be getting the answer in negative. Okay, let us see that. That is, in this case, AN bar is equal to AZ bar, AX bar is equal to AY bar is equal to sine 90 degree, all are 1, their magnitudes are 1. Okay, that is, the equations are AX bar cross AY bar is equal to AZ bar, AY bar cross AZ bar is equal to AX bar, and AZ bar cross AX bar is equal to AY bar. Now, if I change the order of the unit vectors, that is, if the order of unit vectors is reversed, what it means, instead of taking AX bar into AY bar, I take AY bar into AX bar. Then whether the AZ bar will be positive or negative, it will be negative. Okay, it will be negative because I have changed their directions. They should be cyclic, remember. It is called as cyclic. Okay, anti-clockwise direction, but it is cyclic. X to Y, Y to Z, Z to X. It is cyclic. Okay, you cannot go say that I am moving from Y to X, it is cyclic. What is meant by cyclic? It is one direction. Anti-clockwise means now we are taking it as cyclic. X to Y, Y to Z, Z to X. Instead of taking from X to Y, if I take Y to X, it doesn't become cyclic. Okay, it is in the opposite direction. I have changed the direction. Hence, if it is AY bar cross AX bar, it is minus AZ bar. If it is AZ bar cross AY bar, that is reversed, that is minus AX bar. And AX bar cross AZ bar is minus AY bar. If order of unit vectors is reversed, the result is negative of the remaining third unit vector, and hence we are getting these equations. Okay. Are you following here, students? Yes. I hope everyone are following here. Yes. Students? Everyone are following here, right? Yes, please.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Fine. The same thing I have illustrated here. This can be remembered by the circle indicating cross product of unit vectors as shown. That is, if it is in the anti-clockwise direction, take AX, AY, AZ. x to y or y to z or z to x is positive, if I just change the order of this, instead of taking from x to y, if I take y to x or the some other terms, then it will be negative. Here I have shown the negative result. X to y, y to z, clockwise direction. If I go in the clockwise, x to z, z to y and y to x, then the answer will be in negative. As cross product of vector with itself is zero, we can write ax bar cross ax bar is equal to ay bar cross ay bar is equal to az bar cross az bar is equal to zero. Okay, because we know that cross product of the vector with itself is zero. Just now we considered a point wherein we wrote it as a bar cross a bar is equal to, or a vector a bar into vector a bar is equal to zero, and hence the cross product of the unit vectors with itself is also zero. That is this equation. Okay, result is applicable for unit vectors in the other coordinate systems also. When we consider the spherical system or the cylindrical system, then there also the same rule holds good. The same rule holds good. That is, if they are cyclic, the answer is positive. Their cross product is positive. Okay, if they it is in the anti, in the clockwise direction, or if we change the order of the terms, if you reverse the order of the terms, then the answer will be negative. Here it is shown the cylindrical system where we are having R, phi and Z, R to phi, phi to Z, Z to phi. In the anti-clockwise direction, answer is positive. Similarly, for spherical system, R, theta, phi. R to theta, theta to phi, and phi to R. Anti-clockwise direction, spherical system, it is positive. That is, AR bar cross A phi bar is equal to AZ bar. AR bar, if I cross it with A phi bar, then I will get AZ bar. Is it not? Then, A theta bar cross A phi bar. A theta bar cross A phi bar, that will give me what? A theta bar cross A phi bar, that will give me AR bar, correct? That is, you have to go in the cyclic order, cyclic, anticlockwise. If it is R cross theta, it will give me phi, A phi. If it is theta cross A theta cross A phi, it is AR. If it is A phi cross AR, then it is A theta. It will give the next one, okay? But note that clockwise direction gives negative result. Cross product in determinant form. Let us find out the cross product in the determinant form, whatever we have analyzed now. Consider the two vectors in the Cartesian system. That is A vector as AX, AX bar plus AY, AY bar. Note down these two equations, students. A bar is equal to AX, AX bar plus AY, AY bar plus AZ, AZ bar. And B bar is equal to BX, AX bar plus BY, AY bar plus BZ, AZ bar. Then find out the cross product of the two vectors. That is A cross B. Find out this, students. Note down these two equations first in your notebook. A bar is equal to AX, AX bar plus AY, AY bar plus AZ, AZ bar. And B bar is equal to BX, AX bar plus BY, AY bar plus BZ, AZ bar. Then find their cross product, A cross B. Just as you found out yesterday, the dot product, A dot B. How many terms will be zero here, students? In yesterday's dot product, six terms were zero and we got only three terms. Here, how many terms will be zero for the cross product? Let us see that. Just look here. A bar cross B bar. That is AX. Okay. AX, BX, first term with first term. AX, BX of AX bar cross AX bar. Then first term with second term plus ax by of ax bar cross ay bar first with third plus ax bz of ax bar cross az bar. Similarly for the others, second with first, second with second, second with third, then third with first, third with second term, third of first equation with third of second term, second equation. Okay, then if we do that, then we are getting these terms. We are getting these terms. Okay, let us see here what are these terms. Ax bar cross ax bar, how much it is? Ax bar cross ax bar, it is 0 or 1? Cross product of vector with itself, it is 0. I have written here 0, right? First term will become 0 plus ax bar cross ay bar, it is anti-clockwise, cyclic. Okay, it will give me the other vector. Okay, ax bar cross ay bar is az bar, hence it is ax by az bar, second term. Then ax bz of ax bar cross az bar, x y z, think of the cyclic, this one you have to remember here, x y z. Now what is our product here? X to z, x to z. Okay, if it is x to z, then what will be our answer? X to z, x is here, z is here, it is opposite clockwise direction, x to z, that will give me ay bar, but it is minus ay bar, minus ay bar. Okay, you have to go according to this diagram, it is minus ay bar, hence I have written here minus ay bar. Okay, minus ay bar, you can see here minus ay bar, minus ax bz into ay bar, minus ay bar. Similarly write down for the other terms. Okay, similarly write down for the other terms, then finally we will get the answer as ay. Just group the similar terms. This is our ax, ax is here, minus az by ax bar. Then one more ax term is here, ay bz ax bar. That is ay bz minus of az by into ax bar. Then y terms, this is a one y term here. Then one more y term is here. That is, it will be az bx minus ax bz into ay bar plus of next term ax by minus ax by minus ay bx into az bar. Okay, we are grouping the similar terms and we are taking the common. Fine. Result can be expressed in determinant form like this. You can just cross verify at home how, if you expand this determinant, that is a bar cross b bar is equal to ax bar ay bar az bar, then their components ax ay az and component of the second vector bx by and bz in the determinant form. Note that it is not the matrix, it is the determinant. Okay, that means if you expand this determinant, you should get the same equation here as you are getting here. Examination, they may ask prove by determinant method or cross verify, or say prove that a bar cross b bar is equal to this equation. Okay, they may give this a bar cross b bar is equal to this equation, or they may say a bar cross b bar is equal to this determinant, prove that. Okay, or expand it. Okay, so if they give this, then you have to first a bar cross b bar, you have to first derive this equation, and you have to say that this can be expressed in determinant form as a bar cross b bar. Then you have to expand this determinant, that is ax bar, this row will go, this column will go, you get ay bz minus by az, then minus of ay bar, this row will go, this column will go, ax bz minus bx into az, then plus az bar, this row will go, first row will go, last column will go, that is ax by minus bx ay. If you expand this and if you slightly rearrange the terms, you can just try out at home as homework, then we'll get this same equation here as that we are getting here, this equation. Then similarly, I can write for the cylindrical system a bar cross b bar as a bar a phi bar a z bar, then ar a phi a z, that is r phi and z component of vector a, then r phi and z component of the second vector, that is the b vector, br b phi and b z. Okay, similarly for the spherical system also, a bar cross b bar is r theta phi, ar bar a theta bar a phi bar, then ar a theta a phi and br b theta b phi. Then what are the applications of cross product, students? It is used to find the direction of the force experienced by the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field. That is, we know the formula, F is equal to BIL. What is that? F is the force experienced by the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field. Then B is the magnetic field strength, L is the length of the conductor, and I is the current flowing through the conductor. We have studied this in your first hour level, first year level. Okay, first year level in our basic electrical subject. Okay, and it is also used to find the torque, that is torque or the moment of the force. What is the torque given by? It is given by the force multiplied by the perpendicular distance. That is, R bar is the perpendicular distance and F bar is the force. That is, R bar into F bar into sine of theta between the R bar and F bar multiplied by the unit vector An bar. Simple. Okay. These are two applications of the vector product or the cross product. Okay. Take this example, students. Given two coplanar vectors, obtain the unit vector normal to the plane containing the vectors A bar and B bar. Note down these two vectors first. A bar is equal to 3x bar plus 4ay bar minus 5az bar, and B bar is equal to minus 6ax bar plus 2ay bar plus 4az bar. A simple example. What is given here? Two vectors are given, coplanar vectors in the same plane. We have to find the unit vector normal or perpendicular to the plane containing the vectors A bar and B bar. The unit vector which is perpendicular or normal to the plane containing these two vectors A bar and B bar. That is what we have to find out. How to go about the solution, students, here? What is the point here? The fundamental here is unit vector normal to the plane containing the vectors A bar and B bar is nothing but the unit vector in the direction of cross product of A bar and B bar. What is meant by unit vector normal to the plane containing vectors A bar and B bar? It is nothing but the direction of their cross product. Yes or no? Direction of the cross product of the vectors A bar and B bar is our unit vector. Correct? That is A bar cross B bar is equal to AX bar, AY bar, AZ bar, write it in determinant form. Then component of X component of A, that is 3, Y component of A, that is 4, Z component of A, that is minus 5. Similarly, for B vector, X component of B, that is minus 6, Y component of B, that is plus 2, Z component of B, that is plus 4. Then solve this determinant. Solve this determinant, students, and tell me the answer, what you are getting. A bar cross B bar, expand it and tell me the answer. How we are expanding, students? Just here, AX bar, it is, that's now I told. So for the first row will go, first column will go, you get 4 minus 5, 2 and 4 in the determinant, and minus AY bar, this will be minus AY bar, student, second one. Then this row will go, this column will go, it is 3 minus 5 minus 6, 4, 3 minus 5 minus 6, 4, then plus AZ bar if you take, it is 3, 4 minus 6, 2. This row will go and this column will go, you are getting 3, 4 minus 6, 2. Then expand this, you'll get 4, 4 is 16. 16 plus 10, 26 AX bar, and this will be plus 18 AY bar, then this will be plus 30 AZ bar, plus 30 AZ bar. Okay. This is the vector 26 AX bar plus 18 AY bar plus 30 AZ bar. Okay. So this is how we are getting the vector, students, here. Next is you have to find the unit vector. What vector we have found out here? It is A bar cross B bar, is it not? A bar cross B bar. This is A bar cross B bar is this. 26 AX bar plus 18 AY bar plus 30 AZ bar. What we are supposed to find out here, students? Yes, please. What we are supposed to find out here? The unit vector, correct? The unit vector we are supposed to find. That is, unit vector of A bar plus B bar is along the perpendicular direction. That is, with the A bar and B bar planes. A bar and B bar vectors in the same planes. So, unit vector, how we are finding the unit vector? Anybody can tell me? What is the way in finding the unit vector? Yes, anyone?
Sir, given vector divided by square root of the coefficients of that vectors.
Excellent. Fine. That is, unit vector is given by the given vector divided by its magnitude. Simple. given vector divided by its magnitude gives the unit vector. What is the given vector? It is a bar cross b bar. Write it. So 26 ax bar plus it is please make a note of it. It is plus 18 ay bar and plus 30 az bar divided by its magnitude. That is square root of 26 square plus 18 square plus 30 square. If we simplify this, then the answer will be in terms of vector. It is a vector, hence it is 0.5964 ax bar plus 0.4129 ay bar plus 0.6882 az bar. This is a unit vector normal to plane a bar and b bar. Just cross verify your answer, students, quickly, whether you're getting this answer.
Yes, sir.
Getting fine. Okay, students. This is how we all have to solve this example, students. If the two vectors are given, and if they're asking the unit vector normal to plane containing vectors a bar and b bar, then this is how we have to find out. Okay. In today's class, students, we have discussed, starting from the vector product or cross product. What is vector product or cross product? Then their properties. We have discussed various properties of cross product. Okay. And next one, we have discussed how to express the cross product in determinant form. Okay. Then proper applications of cross product. Applications of cross product. Okay. Then finally, we have solved an example on the cross product. I hope everybody have understood. Any difficulties here, students? Any difficulties here? Yes, please. Everybody understood? Virpaksh Goda? Is it clear, Virpaksh Goda?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any difficulty here?
No, sir.
Okay. Pallavi Darigowda, any problem in understanding? Pallavi? Deepa Lamani? Deepa?
Yes, sir.
Any problem, Deepa?
No, sir.
Everything is clear? Today's class, yes, whatever we discussed?
Yes, sir. All
right. Okay, fine. Then for the test, your test will be held once the portion is completed. Requested, sir. Okay. Then the test, whatever is concerned with the field theory, that test will be held after the portion is being covered. Maybe probably in the next week. Okay. So that is what the information I wanted to convey you all. Thank you.